Hello students, today we are going to see statistics. We know that statistics deals with data collected for specific purpose. We can make decisions about the data by analyzing and interpreting it. In earlier classes, we have studied methods of representing data graphically and in tabular form. We have also studied the methods of finding a representative value for the given data. This value is called the measure of central tendency. Its mean, arithmetic mean, median and mode are the three measures of central tendency. So what is measures of dispersion? The dispersion or scatter in data is measured on the basis of the observation and the types of the measure of central tendency used there. There are following measures of dispersion: range, quartile deviation, mean deviation and standard deviation. In this chapter, we shall study all of these measures of dispersion except the quartile deviation. Range. We find the difference of maximum and minimum value of each series. This difference is called the range of the data. So range of a series is maximum value minus minimum value. The range of the data gives us a rough idea of variability or scatter, but does not tell about the dispersion of the data from a measure of central tendency. For this purpose, we need some other measure of variability. Clearly, such measure must depend upon the difference or deviation of the values from the central tendency. The important measure of dispersion, which depend upon the deviations of the observation from a central tendency, are mean deviation and standard deviation. Let us discuss them in detail. Let's see what is mean deviation. The deviation of an observation x from a fixed value a, which is the difference, that is x minus a. In order to find the dispersion of values of x from a central value a, we find the deviations about a. An absolute measure of dispersion is the mean of these deviations. To find the mean, we must obtain the sum of the deviations, but we know that a measure of central tendency lies between the maximum and minimum value of a set of observation. Therefore, some of the deviations will be negative and some will be positive. Thus, the sum of deviations may vanish. Moreover, the sum of the deviations from mean x is 0. Mean of deviation is sum of deviations by number of observations, which is equal to 0 by n, which is equal to 0. Thus, finding the mean of deviations about mean is not of any use for us as far as the measure of dispersion is concerned. Let us now learn how to calculate mean deviation about mean and mean deviation about median for various types of data. So mean deviation for ungrouped data. Let n observations be x1, x2, x3, etc. till xn. The following steps are involved in the calculation of mean deviation about mean or median. The first step is calculate the measure of central tendency about which we are to find the mean deviation. Let it be a. Second step, find the deviation of each xi from a, that is x1 minus a, x2 minus a, x3 minus a, etc., xn minus a. Step 3 is find the absolute values of the deviation, that is drop the minus sign if it is there. Then it is modulus of x1 minus a, modulus of x2 minus a till modulus of xn minus a. So step 4 is find the mean of the absolute values of the deviation. This mean is the mean deviation about a, that is mean deviation about a, which is sigma I equal to 1 to n modulus of x minus a by n. So mean deviation is x bar, which is equal to 1 by n sigma I equal to 1 to n xi minus x bar, where x bar is mean. And mean deviation about median, which is 1 by n sigma I equal to 1 to n modulus of xi minus m, where m is the median. Let's see some exercise problem to find the mean deviation of median and mean for ungrouped data. So first one is find the mean deviation about the mean for the data. Data is given as 4, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12, 13 and 17. Here the number of observation is 8. So finding the mean, which is x bar equal to sigma xi by n. The sum of the observations, that is 4 plus 7 plus 8 plus 9 plus 10 plus 12 plus 13 plus 17, which is 80. So number of observation is n. So sum of the observation is 80. So x bar equal to sigma xi by n, which is 80 by 8, which is equal to 10. So we get x bar as 10. Now we are going to find mean deviation about mean. The formula is to find is sigma xi minus x bar by n. Here xi minus x bar. So 4 minus 10, which is minus 6, and 7 minus 10, which is minus 3, and 8 minus 10, which is minus 2. 9 minus 10 is minus 1. Here we are going to subtract this. Then modulus of xi minus x bar. So negative will vanish. It will become 6, 3, 2, 1, 0, 2, 3, and 7. So sum of these are 24. Mean deviation, which is equal to sigma xi minus x bar by n. Here n is a number of observations. And sigma xi minus x bar is the sum of these numbers. That is 6 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1. Plus 2 plus 3 plus 7, which is 24. So we get 24 by 8, which is equal to 3. Then mean deviation equal to 3. Third question, find the mean deviation about median for the data. The data is given. So we have to arrange the data in ascending order from small to big. Here I have arranged this data 10, 11, 11, 12, 13, 13. 14, 16, 16, 17, 17, and 18. So number of observation is 12, which is even number. So median is the average of 6th and 7th observation. Here 6th observation is 13 and 7th observation is 14. So 13 plus 14, 27 by 2, which is 13.5. So m is 13.5. I have arranged this data in xi. So this column is modulus of xi minus m. M is 13.5. So modulus of xi minus 13.5. So the first data is 10. So 10 minus 13.5, which is 3.5. As it is the absolute value, so no negatives. So it will become positive. So 10 minus 13.5, which is 3.5. So 11 minus 13.5. Modulus of 11 minus 13.5, which is 2.5. Again, it's 2.5. 12 minus 13.5, which is 1.5. So 13 minus 13.5, which is 0.5. So again, it's 0.5. Then it is 14 minus 13.5, which is 0.5. 16 minus 13.5, we get 2.5. And 17 minus 13.5, we get 3.5. And 18 minus 13.5, we get 4.5. So sum of these are 28. So number of observation is 12. So mean deviation about median, which is 1 by n, sigma I equal to 1 to n, modulus of xi minus m, which is equal to 1 by 12 into 28. So modulus sum of the xi minus m, which is 28, here it is 28, and number of observation is 12. So 28 by 12, which is equal to 2.33. So mean deviation about median is 2.33. So these are the questions for ungrouped data, finding the mean deviation of mean and median. Now let's see mean deviation for grouped data. We know that data can be grouped into two ways, discrete frequency distribution and continuous frequency distribution. Let us discuss the method of finding mean deviation for both the types of the data. So first one, discrete frequency distribution. Let the given data consist of n distinct values x1, x2 till xn occurring with frequencies f1, f2, etc., fn respectively. This data can be represented in the tabular form as given below, which is called the discrete frequency distribution. So first row is x and second row is the frequency. So first row x1, x2, x3 till xn and the frequencies are f1, f2, f3 till fn. For discrete frequency distribution, so let's find a mean deviation about mean. First of all, we find the mean x bar of the given data by using the formula x bar equal to sigma I equal to 1 to n fi xi by sigma fi. So first we have to find the mean value using the formula x bar equal to sigma fi xi by sigma fi, where I belongs to 1 to n. which is equal to 1 by n sigma I equal to 1 to n fi xi. Here sigma fi xi denotes the sum of the products of observation xi with their respective frequencies. The product of xi and fi. Then n equal to sigma fi, which is the sum of the frequencies. Thus we find the deviations of observation xi from the mean x bar and take their absolute values. So modulus of xi minus x bar for all I equal to 1 to n. After this we find the mean of the absolute values of the deviation, which is the required mean deviation about the mean. Thus mean deviation of x bar, which is sigma fi into xi minus x bar by sigma fi, which is 1 by n sigma I equal to 1 to n fi into modulus of xi minus x bar. And mean deviation about median. We find the mean deviation of the median of the given discrete frequency distribution whose cumulative frequency is equal to or just greater than n by 2, where n is the sum of frequencies. So mean deviation of median, which is equal to 1 by n sigma I equal to 1 to n fi xi minus m. So modulus of xi minus m. So let's see the second method, continuous frequency distribution. So it is a series in which the data are classified into different class intervals without gaps along with the respective frequencies. For example, marks obtained by 100 students are present in a continuous frequency distribution as follows. So 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, etc. till 60. And the number of students is given as 12, 18, 27, 20, 17 and 6. So mean deviation about mean. While calculating the mean of a continuous frequency distribution, we made the assumption that the frequency in each class is centered at its midpoint. We write the midpoint of each given class and proceed further as discrete frequency distribution to find the mean deviation. Seventh question, find the mean deviation about the median. Here the data and frequencies are given. So I have written xi, which is 5, 7, 9, 10, 12 and 15, and frequency is 8, 6, 2, 2, 2 and 6. So sum of the frequencies is 26. Here we are going to find cumulative frequency. So first number is 8. So we have written 8 here. Then 8 plus 6, which is 14. And 14 plus 2, which is 16. Then 16 plus 2, which is 18. And again 18 plus 2 is 20. And 20 plus 6 is 26. I have to get this sum of the frequency 26. Then this is correct. So cumulative frequency is adding the frequencies. So first frequency we have to write as it is 8. And 8 plus 6. Then 14 plus 2. Then 16 plus 2. Then 18 plus 2. Then 20 plus 6, which is 26. Then we have to find median. Median is finding n by 2. Here n is 26, so n by 2 is 26 by 2, which is 13. Here CF is just greater than 13 is 14, and the corresponding value of x is 7. So median is 7. Then we have to find the absolute value of this, so modulus of xi minus 7. So xi is 5. And median is 7. So 5 minus 2, which is 3. Then 7 minus 7, which is 0. Then 9 minus 7, which is 2. Then 10 minus 7, which is 3. Again 12 minus 7, which is 5. 15 minus 7, which is 8. Now we are going to find fi into xi minus m. Here fi is the frequency. We are going to multiply this 8 into 2. 6 into 0, then 2 into 2, like that. So 8 into 2, which is 16, then 6 into 0, which is 0, then 2 into 2, which is 4. Here fi is 2 and xi minus 7 is 3. So 2 into 3, which is 6, 2 into 5 is 10, then 6 into 8 is 48. So sum of these are 84, adding this 16 plus 4 plus 6 plus 10 plus 48, which is 84. Then mean deviation about median is 1 by n, sigma I equal to 1 to n, fi, xi minus m. Here the sum of these are 84 and n is 26. So we get 1 by 26 into 84, or 84 by 26, which is nothing but 3.23. So mean deviation about median, which is equal to 3.23. Now we are going to see question 9. So this is used continuous frequency distribution. So using continuous frequency distribution, we are going to find the mean deviation about mean and mean deviation about median. So 9th question is, data is given income per day. So it's given as 0 to 100, 100 to 200, 200 to 300 till 700 to 800. So number of persons for each intervals, it's given as 4, 8, 9, 10, 7, 5, 4, 3. I have written in column wise. So income per day, 0 to 100. So it's a continuous frequency distribution. We are getting 0 to 100, and another interval starts from 100 to 200, then 200 to 300. So it's a continuous frequency distribution till 800, and the frequency is given as 4, 8, 9, 10, 7, 5, 4, 3. We are going to find the mid value of xi, that is 0 to 100, so 100 by 2, which is 50. Then 100 plus 200, which is 300 by 2, which is 150. We are going to find the mid value of these two. So between 200 and 300, the mid value is 250. Otherwise, we can find the average of these two. So 300 plus 400 by 2, which is 350. Then 400 plus 500, which is 900 by 2, which is 450. Then 500 plus 600 by 2, which is 550. So otherwise, we can find in between the values, mid value of 600, 700, which is 650, 700 and 800, we have 750. Now we are going to find FIXI, that is frequency is given 489, then mid value. Just now we have found the mid value of these intervals. We are going to multiply these two. So 50 into 4, which is 200, 150 into 8, 1200, 250 into 9, 2250, 350 into 10, 3500, 450 into 7, 3150, 550 into 5, 2750, 650 into 4, 2600, 750 into 3, 2250. So the sum of the frequencies are 50. When we add these values, 4 plus 8 plus 9 plus 10 plus 7 plus 5 plus 4 plus 3, which is 50, and sum of these FIXI, we get 17900. Now we are going to find the modulus of xi minus 358. So x bar is 358. How will you find x bar? X bar is nothing but mean, which is equal to 1 by n, sigma I equal to 1 to n, FIXI. We know that FIXI is 17,900 and 1 by n, which is 50, the sum of the frequencies. So we get 17,900 by 50, which is 358. So the formula is to find is modulus of xi minus x bar. X bar is 358. Here xi is 50 and x bar is 358. We are going to subtract this and find the absolute value. So modulus of something, modulus of some negative value will become positive. So 50 minus 358, we get 308 minus of 308. So modulus of minus 308 is positive. And again 150 minus 358, we get 208. 250 minus 358, we get 108. And 350 minus 358, we get 8. Like that, we have to subtract xi minus x bar. Then fi into modulus of xi minus x bar. Just now we have found xi minus x bar. And fi is nothing but the frequencies. Now we are going to find the product of these two. That is 4 into 308, which is 1232, 8 into 208, which is 1664, 9 into 108, which is 972, 10 into 8, which is 80. Now we are going to find the product of other numbers also, so that we get the sum of these numbers as 7896. Then mean deviation about mean, which is 1 by n, sigma I equal to 1 to n, fi into modulus of xi minus x bar. So sum of these are 707,896. So divided by 50. N is 50. Sum of the frequencies. So 7896 by 50, which is 157.92. So we get mean deviation about mean, which is 157.92. 12th one, calculate the mean deviation about the median age for the distribution of 100 persons given below. So age is given 16 to 20, 21 to 25, 26 to 30 till 55. So it's not a continuous intervals. So we are going to change this as continuous frequency distribution. Here it's 16 to 20. So left side we have to subtract. So 16 minus 0.5. Here we are going to add plus 0.5. Here 16 minus 0.5 is 15.5. 20 plus 0.5 is 20.5. Then here we have left side 21. So 21 minus 0.5 is 20.5. On the right side we have 25. Add 0.5, we get 25.5. So that we can get the continuous intervals. So 15.5 to 20.5. 20.5 to 25.5. So we get the continuous frequency distribution. And the frequency is given as 5, 6, 12, 14, 26, 12, 6 and 9. So some of these frequencies are 100. Now we have to find the mid value of this intervals. So average of these two, 15.5 plus 20.5 by 2, we get 18. So 20.5 plus 25.5 by 2, we get 23. So that we get 28, 33, 38, 43, 48 and 53, the other mid values of these intervals. Here Fi is given, sum of the frequencies are 100. Then we need to find the cumulative frequency, which is the sum of the frequencies. The first number is 5, write as it is. Then adding these two. So 5 plus 6, which is 11, then 11 plus 12, which is 23, then 23 plus 14, 37, 37 plus 26, 63, 63 plus 12, 75, 75 plus 16, 91, and 91 plus 9 is 100. So we have to get the sum of the frequencies 100, then adding of these numbers, which we get the cumulative frequency will be correct. How to find median? So median we have to find using the formula L plus N by 2 minus CF by F into H. So L is lower limit. Here N by 2 is 100 by 2, which is 50. Then CF, which is greater than 50, is 63. We have to take this class. So 35.5 to 40.5. Then frequency is 26. We have to take the CF, which is previous to this number, which is 37. So I am again repeating, N by 2 is 50. We have to take CF, which is greater than 50. So it is 63. We have to take that class. So 35.5 to 40.5. So then the lower limit of the class is 35.5, which is L. Then the frequency is 26. Then CF is the previous number we have to take, which is 37. So L is 35.5, frequency is 26, and CF is 37. The class size of this is 35.5 to 40.5. We have the class size, which is H, which is 5. So the formula is L plus N by 2 minus CF by F into H. L is 35.5 plus N by 2 is 50. Minus CF is 37 and F is 26 into class size H is 5. So we get 35.5 plus 2.5, which is 38. So median is 38. Now we are going to find modulus of XI minus 38. Here XI is 18. 18 minus 38 is minus 20. So modulus of minus 20 is plus 20. All the values will be in positive. Then 23 minus 38 is 15. 28 minus 38 is 10, 33 minus 38 is 5, 38 minus 38 is 0, 43 minus 38 is 5, 48 minus 38 is 10, then 53 minus 38 is 15. So now we are going to find the product of these two, that is Fi into modulus of Xi minus 38. 5 into 20, 100, 6 into 15, 90. So 12 into 10, 120. So we need to find the product of these two so that we get the sum of the absolute values into the frequency, we get 735. So the formula is to find mean deviation about median, which is 1 by n, sigma I equal to 1 to n, Fi into modulus of Xi minus m. So 735 by 100, which is 7.35. So mean deviation about median, which is 7.35. So in this video, we have seen mean deviation about mean and median for ungrouped data and grouped data. Thank you, students.